Hey everybody, this is Blake here at DD. Recently we came out with our super small 2000 watt monoblock, seen right here, the SS2000. Today I'm going to be doing some testing for y'all on our Audio Precision APX515 audio analyzer. Anyways, I'm going to walk you through each of the measurements we're going to do, then we're going to take them one at a time. And at the end, I'm going to run it all as a sequence so we can generate a report and share all that data with you guys. First off, we've got the level and gain and THD. This is basically a dyno run. And the Audio Precision can do a dyno run where it sweeps through the output, chooses exactly 1% THD, just like the Amplifier dyno you're all familiar with. Personally, I prefer these measurements because what I can do is I can set the generator level to the exact same, so it's getting the exact same output both times. And both of these measurements take a while. They sit the amplifier at that full output for a couple of seconds, and that makes sure you're getting a true continuous measurement instead of just a quick sweep and a snapshot. It's a harder test and it doesn't read as high, but I think it's more accurate and I prefer it. So I've got the first two are going to be set up for 1%, and then we're going to do these two at 10% THD or clipping. Next up, we're going to do the frequency response. This is a full range amplifier, so we want to see what it'll sound like. And lastly is the step level sweep. This is going to show the distortion versus the output at all levels. So let's start. First off, we've got 1% THD sitting right at 2 kilowatts there. And just to verify, yep, we're right at 1% THD, just under it actually. Oh, and down here we've got the oscilloscope that'll show you guys exactly what the amplifier is outputting. This is going to be the 10% THD test, sitting at 2.2 kilowatts there. And just right at 10% THD, exactly what we want to see. Next up is the frequency response. You can see we've got a tiny bit of roll off down here, and then that's not really a problem. Now we do have quite a bit of high frequency roll off starting at about 5 kilohertz. So I might not want to run this amplifier on tweeters. Although honestly, if you're running a 2000 watt amplifier on tweeters, having this roll off is going to make it sound better anyways. You don't need nearly that much power, honestly. And last but not least, we've got the step level sweep. This one is actually the most difficult for amplifiers to run because it takes a while and sits the amp right at its max output. And amplifier completed it just fine. You can see we sat just right under 1% THD this whole time. Super even, didn't have any big nasty spikes. Got a little bit right here, but nothing too bad. And then didn't cross 1% until right about 2000 watts, which is exactly what we want to see. Next, I'm just going to run this whole thing as a sequence to generate a report, and that'll let me share all that data with you guys so you can see exactly what the amplifier is capable of. And this is the first amplifier we're showing you guys on the Audio Precision, but this isn't going to be the last, and if there are any that you guys want to see, make sure to leave it in the comments. Okay, we got the sequence. I'm going to save this, share it with all of you guys, and have a good one.